Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of God, the Compassionate, the Merciful. Thank you all for coming today. We'll try and be as quick as possible. We're here to discuss one case in particular of an American Muslim barred from entering his own country, but we also have other cases that seem to be outlining a disturbing phenomenon that's taking place. My name is Ibrahim Hooper. I'm National Communications Director with the Council on American-Islamic Relations. First, we'll hear from our Executive Director, Nihad Awad. Then we'll hear from a young man who was stopped overseas and interrogated and underwent some difficult circumstances. Then we'll hear from Khadija Athman, CARE's Civil Rights Manager. And we'll take some questions after that. So first of all, Nihad Awad, CARE National Executive Director.
Thank you, Ibrahim. Good morning. First of all, let me say that we American Muslims firmly believe that the government has the duty to protect America from any harm. These measures have to be legal. The government, when it uses these measures, they have to be illegal. We are witnessing what appears to be a new policy by the Obama administration of barring American citizens from coming home based on suspicions. We are concerned that the FBI interrogates American citizens abroad or renders American citizens abroad to governments where they will be interrogated in a condition of forced exile. These interrogations mainly are taking place without due process, with techniques that amount to be a form of rendition, a policy that has been used by the Bush administration, has been condemned by civil libertarians, and even by President Obama himself. These interrogations are taking place without an oversight and without limits. When counsels, legal counsels of these individuals asked to be present, or whether physically or on the phone, while these interrogations are taking place, they have been ignored. These tactics have adverse effect on American citizens, especially young American citizens, and the feeling of alienation. This should be of concern to the government, to society, and to Congress. The apparent illegal use of these tactics fly in the face of President Obama's commitment to abandon unconstitutional policies instituted under the previous administration. If the FBI would like to question American citizens abroad, they should do so by allowing them to come to the United States, where they are able to maintain their constitutional rights free from intimidations. We are very concerned that this apparent targeting of American Muslims sends the very wrong message to American Muslims that they are second-class citizens. I wrote a letter to Attorney General Eric Holder yesterday asking him to investigate these serious allegations and that he should take all remedial actions that are necessary based on the results of his investigation. We also asked the Department of Justice to allow Americans to return home, and if there are any reasons to charge them with anything, they should be first investigated where they can maintain their rights, their constitutional rights. We ask also American Muslims to understand that if the government has legitimate concerns about these individuals who are suspected of being involved in any actions, that the government also should take all necessary measures that are under the Constitution. And what we feel is that these things are taking place abroad, where in some governments or in locations like, for example, in Egypt, in this particular case, individuals have been detained, have been assaulted, and they have not been allowed to be with their lawyers. We believe that these things should be a thing of the past, but unfortunately they are taking place under the watch of President Obama. So we remind him that his commitment to constitutional rights is very critical to credibility, to the credibility of this administration, that the Bush administration policies are thing of the past and they are not just repeated, unfortunately, just because it's happening overseas without the knowledge of the American public and civil rights organizations. That should be of concern to all of us, American citizens, the Congress, and the media as well.
My name is Yusuf Uhili. I'm a 19-year-old American citizen who was born in Fairfax, Virginia. Last year, I traveled to Sana'a, Yemen to visit my older brother and to study Arabic. On May 4th, we flew to Cairo, Egypt to return to the United States. In transit to the United States, we were prevented from doing so by Egyptian air employees after being directed to the U.S. Embassy in Cairo. A man wearing a suit soon entered and asked me some questions. When I asked him who he was, he claimed to be the CIA and said that I would not go home until he put me, I would not go home if I didn't answer these questions, and he would put me in prison. He interrogated me for a short time. I then asked to use the restroom and I was taken to a small prison in the airport. I was kept there overnight. The next day, after only eating a small piece of bread, I was taken before an Egyptian judge who allowed me to be released. But I wasn't released. Instead, I was put into the back of an Egyptian police car, handcuffed, blindfolded, and driven to what I believe to be the police ministry. I was there and I was placed in a corridor with other prisoners shackled to the wall.
Yahya's family retained an attorney in the United States, and despite the attorney calling the FBI agents not to interrogate or speak to these young men without his presence, the FBI refused to cooperate with this American lawyer and continued to interrogate Yusuf and Yahya without their lawyer. Indeed, the agents told the brothers that if they made use of a private counsel, they would be stuck in Cairo for weeks or even months. As a result, Yahya has been subjected to 8 or 9 interrogations by the FBI. He was also pressured to take a polygraph test. And based on his answers, he was told that he needed to rethink them or he will never, in quotes, never see the United States or your family again.
Yeah. On the civil rights, the two that you referred, are those Muslim Americans that have specifically contacted CARE for assistance? Or?
Yes.
Yeah, I think all these cases are American Muslims, yeah.
Are you against the no-fly list per se? Because I think a lot of people feel that perhaps necessary after the Christmas Day bombings?
Well, we think that the no-fly lists have grown way out of proportion. There has to be some kind of oversight, some kind of legal recourse that you can take if you're put on a no-fly list, that you can say, look, you know, there's no reason for me to be on there. Please clear me. Well, yeah, I mean, these are American-born individuals, an American family, a military family with someone who is in the immediate family who has served in Iraq. So, you know, our government needs to step up to the plate and take whatever is action necessary to, at minimum, allow him to return to the United States. If they have other questions, ask the questions here. And let him have access to an attorney. Let him have all the rights that any American is due.